Our project release prevention of raw materials spillage in grape planning manufacturing. Batch members are Arvindan, myself, Kathikaja, Pushottaman, Sethupathi. We done our project in Rane Grape Planning Limited, Ambattur. Intern Mr. J. Joshua. External guide Mr. Ram Munagar. Abstract. The production of component by hydraulic ramming of powder raw material play an equal role compared to forging casting industry. The powder of varying composition, particular dimension, grind size, density, position, addition are used different production criteria to be obtained. The raw material transportation, ramming, weighing of this powder are more predominantly lead to spillage and subsequently wastage, huge amount of which is neglected. They require manpower and vacuum suction machine to reuse the spilled powder. The project aim is design and fabrication and incorporation of spillage collector to eliminate the wastage and reuse the spilled powder with fairly less manpower. The spillage collector also record to efficient effort handling of raw material.
Introduction. Brake lining is used in braking system which converts a kinetic energy into it. Brake lining is used in drum brakes and disc brakes. It is consists of high tensile materials and high coefficient of dynamic friction. It is capable of high temperature without excessive wear leading in the stopping the brake. There are various raw materials, asperous, non-asperous and reinforced fibers. Asperous and iron powder and friction material, glass fiber resins are the major raw materials. The characteristics of raw materials like high tensile strength, corrosion, friction resistance. The friction materials other than the asperous are used effectively and primarily reinforced fiber in making a brake lining. Steps involved in brake lining manufacturing: mixing, preforming, curing, baking, centrifuging, grinding, chamfering, inspection, tinting and packing. This animation shows the brake lining manufacturing process. This diagram shows that brake lining, mixture machine and preforming machine.
Observation. In this preforming process, while weighing and pouring the mixer on the hydraulic press mold, huge amount of mix has been spilled around a weighing table, the floor and the mold. Due to this, huge amount of raw material get waste in industries. Below table represents the weight of spillage on weighing table. The first column of the table represents the timing of batch 1 and batch 2, and second column represents of average mix on weighing table per machines. Third column represents for all the machines, and the fifth column represents the total weight of mix per shift. In this from first batch, around 82.72 of average mixer are spilled in per machines, and 413.6% gram of spill for all the machines. For total for first batch of around 688.6 grams. Next table column represents the spillage of spillage on the floor, and another table represents the spillage around the mold. And this diagram represents the total spillage weight per shift. From this below table of varying area of like a weighing table floor mold, comparing this around 5755.6 grams of get wasted from the three areas. From the above observation, the raw material spillage is around the mold comparing to spillage around table and floor. So by changing the conventional handling of raw material, we can reduce the spillage around the mold and also reuse the raw material.
For this, we designed and fabricated prototypes, namely container and spillage collector. The container is to replace the conventionally used bucket for easy and effective handling of raw material. It contains four parts, namely outer frame, larger plate, shorter plate and magnet. This diagram shows the design of a container. The green color shows shorter plate, and red color represent the longer plate. The outer frame contains grooves on both vertical and horizontal direction. Longer plate will place on the vertical groove and the shorter plate will move on the horizontal groove. And the magnet will be placed on the bottom of the shorter plate, used to ensure the closeness of the shorter plate. This slide represents the dimension of the different parts of a container. This is our another prototype spillage collector. It will be placed on the hydraulic pressing of mold. Green color represents the aluminium, made up of aluminium, and red color is made up of rubber sheet which is to be connected to the aluminium by the bolt joint. This slide gives the information of a gives information about the dimension of the spillage collector. When we see the spillage collector in a front view, it's in the trapezoidal shape. When we see in a top view, it's in the rectangular shape. Rubber sheet have a cut in a rectangular shape, which is helpful to hold the mold in a particular in a fixed position. This diagram shows the prototypes of the spillage collector. After implementing, the weight of the spillage on the weighing table. This table gives the total information after implementing the prototypes for batch 1 and batch 2 on a weighing table. Second tabular column shows the information of amount of weight spilled on the floor for batch 1 and batch 2 respectively. The third tabular column gives the information about the amount of raw material spilled on the around the mold for batch 1 and batch 2. The below tabular columns gives the total spillage of weight per shift in
result.
As we discussed in the observation, figure 1 gives the information about the spillage quantity in different area of hydraulic press during batch 1. Figure 2 also gives the information about the spillage quantity in different area of hydraulic press during batch 2. By analyzing figure 1, figure 2, maximum percentage of spillage occur in both floor and mold. So we designed and fabricated the container and spillage collector. Container is used to improve the effective handling of a raw material so the spillage can be prevented in floor and mold. Spillage collector is used to collect the raw material which is coming out from the clearance of a mold and ram. This below chart gives the information about the quantity of raw material spillage before and after implementation the prototype in different area. From that we can clearly see the reduction in quantity of raw material spillage in the weighing table, floor and mold. Amount of spillage is high around the mold compared to other area, but we can reuse the raw material which is collected by spillage collector around the mold. Conclusion: the conventional handling of raw material results in spillage. The preforming of a raw material is a continuous process which leads to a huge amount of spillage in a weighing table, on the floor and around the mold. The implementation of spillage collector and the container made the raw material handling more effective and results in reduction of spillage. Thank you.